using air conditioners is getting inflated electricity bills. New Vastu says that if you follow its principles, you can reduce that significantly. More importantly, you will equally reduce the emission of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere, which is produced when using fossil fuels for production of electricity. Now, we will achieve this in two ways. First, by reducing the number of days you need air conditioning during the hot and humid season. And secondly, by reducing the number of hours in a day when you feel the necessity of an air conditioner. If you're on the top floor, make sure that your roof is well insulated so that it slows down the flow of heat from the hot roof surface to the inside of the room. And make sure that the finishing surface of the roof is light colored, preferably white, so that its surface absorbs little heat from the sun's rays shining on it. Of course, you can achieve the same effect or even a better effect if you plant a lawn on the roof or you erect a shade structure over the roof. While the roof is exposed to the hottest sun in the middle of the day, the east-facing and west-facing walls are also exposed to the fury of the sun. The east-facing wall bears the brunt of the morning sun as it rises up from the horizon, and the west-facing wall faces the fury of the afternoon sun from about 2 p.m. till 5:30 p.m. Therefore, it is useful to insulate these walls too, especially the west wall. And this can be done from the inside or from the outside. If you already have a house which doesn't have an insulated wall, you could add insulation from the inside. Put up a board 1.5 inches thick of thermocol and cover it with, let's say, 1/2 inch of plywood. That should do the trick. Now, many builders are building the wall of multi-story buildings with lightweight insulating block, which proved to be beneficial. Make sure that all windows are well protected from the sun outside so that the sun's rays do not fall on the glass and enter the room. This external shade will also protect the room from the diffused radiation that comes from the sky. The shade must be placed externally, like we have over here. Putting the shade inside is no use at all. Like the windows, the external doors should also shut tight. They should have a rebate or a seal at the bottom so that when you close them, the hot air is kept out. And incidentally, this also keeps the creepy crawlies out and also the dust. When it is pleasantly cool outside, open the windows and allow the cool air to pass through the room. The walls and floors will absorb the cools right through the evening and night till early morning. And as it starts to get warm in the morning, shut the doors and the windows. And when it is hot outside, make sure the doors and windows are shut tight. These four steps are essential, and they will do a lot to minimize your seasonal discomfort and to minimize the hours of discomfort during the day and night. But I have one more tip to give you, which is very easy to execute. There are times when the natural breeze has died down and the air is still. Even when you open the window, the breeze does not flow across the house. Now, if you install a small exhaust fan for the kitchen and the toilet, you can switch it on and open windows at the opposite sides of the room. This will pull the cool air from the windows across the room and gradually cool your living space. In any case, it's a good idea to exhaust the hot air of the kitchen and keep it from spreading into the house. I'd like to share with you the results of a study that was done to show you what difference it would make if you do as I told you. The study was done in Indore, Madhya Pradesh, where the summer temperatures can rise to the mid-40s. The results are quite staggering. In this study of a west-facing top floor room on a hot summer day, the indoor temperature reaches 38 degrees Celsius and does not come down below 32 degrees Celsius. This is when there is no external shading on the west-facing windows, the windows are kept closed at all times, and the roof and wall are not insulated. In other words, if you were to rely only on air conditioning to be comfortable in this room, you'll be trying to refrigerate a solar cooker. Now, after taking the measures to protect the room from getting heated up during the day and allowing it to cool down during the night, the indoor temperature of the room comes down dramatically, and that too without the use of air conditioners. The peak temperature comes down from 38 degrees Celsius to 32 degrees Celsius, and the low temperature comes down to 28 degrees Celsius. I've shown you how to attain comfort and well-being with the intelligent use of Vastu principles, such that we maintain our respect for Mother Earth. As I say always, stay comfortable and stay sustainable.